New York, Gotham, the Naked City. I'd heard a lot of bad things about New York, but I'd also heard it was here I'd find the five most beautiful girls in the world. They were models, and they were going to be making a film. The voice on the phone said my job would be easy. I just had to talk to them. A lot of people think models are dumb, as though it would be doubly unfair on everybody else to be blessed with beauty and brains. I didn't know if that was true. All I knew was that these girls had made it to the top. I wasn't even sure what they looked like, but it wasn't hard to find out. I just had to look at any magazine cover. There they were, the million-dollar girls, the supermodels. Bring me to the top, make marriage paradise, and then like so we'll go and I will on your side. Kiss me, tell me out. Loudest for jealous. Impress the yellow press. I take off your jewels and join my point of view. Fill my soul. Bring me to the top. Something had happened to lift these girls above the anonymous parade of the glossy pages, to give them names, personalities, and fan clubs. I had turned on the TV in my hotel room, and there was Cindy Crawford, hosting the MTV Music Awards. From my window, I could see a Times Square billboard, with Linda Evangelista's name up in lights. On the newsstand in the lobby, the latest issue of Time magazine featured Naomi Campbell on the cover. It was a story about the rage for beauty and the phenomenon of the superstar models. Tatiana Patitz was the fourth girl. Her face had launched 1,000 perfumes. And Stephanie Seymour was the fifth. The next morning, I left the city and headed for Long Island. I was told I would find the girls at Jones Beach. Photographers bring their models here to photograph beachwear, usually out of season, when the beach is deserted and cold. My first beauty lesson was patience. Everyone has to wait for the right light, the right mood. Beauty is supposed to come from the inside, but I wasn't so sure after seeing the makeup artist, the girl's best friend, transforming the extraordinary into the sublime. The supermodels are to millions of teenage girls what rock stars are to teenage boys. An adolescent fantasy come true. In their pictures, they radiate magnetic self-assurance. But in reality, they wonder what's next.
I dreamt of being a model. I knew I was a good model, so I wasn't afraid. Mm-hmm. And after 10th year, I just don't know if I would be good at it. I was just feeling floppy in that area, and then I would be really good.
The supermodels are the princesses of a modern-day fairy tale, the daughters of factory workers and broken homes who've gone straight to the bank. But once upon a time, they were the ugly ducklings, even a goosebump girl like Stephanie Seymour.
I was not pretty when I was younger. My brother and my sisters always say, and to think we used to feel sorry for her. Because I wore big glasses, and I was gawky, and I tripped all the time, and I would knock things over, and I was just odd. All my proportions were wrong.
Twiggy was so famous, Gene Shrimpton, that there's such a group right now. There's, you know, there's like a cluster of us that people seem to know. But I think that, and we talked about this before a little bit, that models are glamorous right now when no one else, a lot of people sort of shun glamour for a while, and models still are glamorous because that's what we do. And that's what people, it's because sometimes people don't have that in their life, so they want to look at it and they want to see it. I think that women see pictures of us and they wonder why they don't look like that, but what they don't know is we don't even look like that. You know, I mean it's the whole created image that the whole team makes. Ideally there's no transformation. Ideally you feel as beautiful when you walk in as you do after the 2 hours of hair and makeup, but oh, and there's a kind of physical beauty that's about physically how you look. But I mean, that doesn't last very long. So I mean, it would be silly for me to say that physical beauty is not important for our job, because it is. But I think everyone knows it sounds such a cliche to say that, you know, beauty's on the inside, but it's really true. And I think that someone said once that the face that you have when you're 50 is the face that you deserve.
I was in this coffee shop this morning. And there were these guys. One guy was talking about how his wife was away.
Huh.
And he was saving so much money that he never wanted her to come back. And they were going on and on and on, like, you know, well, you know, women. So funny.
Hey, something.
Their little, it was their private little men. You know, their private little
man.
Yeah, you know, they have a man to man. It's funny though. Parents come in and talk about women. What a pain in the ass they were. Spent too much money.
you think we'll get nominated for an Academy Award?
Marcus, Naomi asks you a direct question. We would respond a direct answer.
Go with the direct question.
Love in a walkie. Love in a walkie. So how do you define love in a walkie? How do you define love in a walkie-talkie?
Come on, Marcus. A joke's a joke. You can talk back, you know.
Pas jouer avec moi. Vous comprenez ça?
Excusez-moi?
Moi, quand je dis pas jouer avec moi.
It was late when we got back to the city. I thought models went to nightclubs to unwind, but the supermodels went to bed. I had a rendezvous downtown the next day with Linda. You'll like her, I was told. Everybody does. Linda is the supermodel's model, the queen of metamorphosis. She changes her hairstyle every 6 months for the demands of the fashion pages. She understands the need to keep interest up in the butterfly world of beauty. And she promised to show off for me a little-known talent.
Mostly sunny and pleasant for tennis or whatever you happen to be doing today. And tonight, clear and cool, low around 62. Tomorrow, pretty much the same deal as today with 85. Enjoy. See you on
1. The flashing the sky was visible within a radius of several hundred miles. The noise of the impact was heard as far north as Elizabeth. We have dispatched a special mobile unit to the scene. And we'll have our commentator, Carl Phillips, with your word of the meantime, we take you to the Hotel Martinet in Brooklyn, where Bobby Millette and his orchestra are offering a program of dance music.
It was a long day, but Linda didn't lose her sense of humour. She isn't impatient with modelling. I had the impression she genuinely likes it. As a teenager, she was obsessed with models and knew everything about her future profession. Her gift for role-playing has made her the inspiration of photographers, a contemporary muse.
Changing's not difficult. It's actually fun. It's a bore to be myself every day. When I'm home and in my life, I'm me. My personality's not changing. It's only my look, and I don't take it seriously. And to change your appearance doesn't mean you're changing your personality or your soul. I'm really flattered to be called a muse, especially from people who I think are extremely talented and the best at what they do. To be called a muse, I'm just flattered. I'm glad I reached that level. Not everybody gets the opportunity to express and live up to their expectations. I'm glad it was discovered. A lot of it had to do with luck. I think somewhere there is a special relationship between me and what you say, the photographers I inspire. You get really close to the people you work with when you work with them. A lot of it doesn't have anything to do with your private life. You spend so much time with these people that they kind of become your family. I'm not the same with each photographer. When I go to work with a particular photographer, I bring the person he wants me to be. I don't just bring me myself. There would be no need to work with different photographers. I could just work with one if I was just going to bring myself. Next. For me, I didn't always treat this job as work. I mean, I like to go to work. And I like it when they give me a new character each day. I love walking in not knowing what the story is. I like it when you come and you give me somebody to be, whether it's somebody we're very inspired by or it's me playing a character. And I guess it's kind of like acting, but in stills. I don't just bring my body to work. I don't consider myself just a hanger for the clothes. And I don't like to go just to do a picture. I go to do a photograph.
She's signing autographs.
Go ahead and bring the accordion and tear it down.
We have to hurry. We're trying to speak to the appointment.
My professional life. I had a wish. My wish is completely personal. It has nothing to do with any of you out there. I just hope that when this is all over, that I take it well. I put my whole heart into it. I know it's gonna come to an end one day. Voila.
I was told not to be surprised if Naomi Campbell didn't show up the next day. 40 technicians were waiting under the Brooklyn Bridge for Naomi to pay tribute to her heroine, Josephine Baker. But the capricious Naomi, who became a star, someone said, because in her mind she already thought she was one, might just decide to get on the Concorde instead.
Parti n'importe où, bras dessus, bras dessous, en chantant des chansons. C'est si bon de se dire des mots doux, de petits rien du tout, mais qui en disant langue, en voyant notre mine ravie, les passants dans la rue nous envient. C'est si bon de guetter dans ses yeux une esprit merveilleux qui donnait la frisson. C'est si bon, ces petites sensations, ça vaut mieux que millions. C'est tellement, tellement bon.
I didn't imagine or have a fantasy to be a star. I had a fantasy to be a great dancer, which I didn't end up being, but never know. Josephine Baker was a reference for me because, first of all, she's my sign. Well, I'm her sign, I'm a Gemini. And people who I know now that knew her then say I have in personality a very similar personality to hers. And also I'm black, so it gave me a chance to be considered for playing her role in the three films they were considering doing. And then I worked for Italian Vogue doing a Josephine Baker story, which to me started a whole new trend again of Josephine Baker. I don't know if I want to be an actress yet. It's just something I want to try. I'm not banking my life on being an actress. I just joined a film agency. I get scripts, and if they're right, then I go for the part, and if they're not, then I just read it. And reading doesn't hurt you. So it's something that if it happens, it happens, but it's not like I have to be an actress, and that's what most people expect from models to be after they're finished with their career. And some get to be and some don't.
Chrome Cadillac car, mink coats, des bijoux jusqu'au cou, tu sais. C'est bon, ces petites sensations. Peut-être quelqu'un avec un petit yacht, non? Oh, c'est bon.
Best location. It's the best location dinner lunch I have.
What?
Yeah.
Did you fuck?
Yeah. No, give me this one, right?
Today I had the cover of Time magazine, but I don't know what it feels like yet because I only just had it today. It's only been a matter of hours, but it feels, it feels like a better achievement than any fashion magazine I could ever have. And I thought that having American Vogue cover was the biggest achievement that I could get in terms of magazines and glossies, but Time's better.
Okay.
I give you one more chance. You hear me? Head down. Give me the sky down. The limit
Derek,
can't get down.
You had to admire Naomi. She knows her mind, even if she changes it often. To let people know, she brings her own portable phone with her. That way, no one can tell her to get off. There was no doubt that Cindy Crawford would be there on time. She had brought along a movie script to read while the crew got ready. Models are always reading movie scripts. The epitome of American beauty, Cindy takes her role as supermodel and MTV star seriously.
As when you first start modeling, you set certain goals, like you want to do a Cosmo cover, you want to do a Vogue cover, you want a cosmetic contract. And so far, those goals I've achieved, but I think what I'm working on now is taking the momentum that I've built in modeling and using that to go other places. It's not that I didn't want to be a model. I mean, it's not like I didn't want to be a model, it's just I never thought about being a model. I thought about being the first woman president or a doctor or So. I mean, straight modeling, I've sort of done that. I mean, I have a show and I do interviews. Interviewing, yeah, that's fun. That's probably the only part of it that I do, that I would continue doing. It's probably perfect that I fell into this because I was ambitious. I wanted to do something. I wanted to make my mark, but I didn't know doing what, so I guess I got my chance.
There's this thing they call road rash, when you leave the bike and hit the pavement. You leave a lot of flesh on the pavement. It's called like road rash. So you don't ride around it's just the exhaust pipe.
That's exhaust.
That's the one you don't want to touch.
That's the exhaust.
That's the exhaust.
I know nothing.
Because the bike's exhausted.
I don't know. I'm not signing bodies. The weirdest thing.
Feels good to me.
You know, you can't feel anything through that.
Might as well
like everybody else.
We just call it a group.
I spell it with a V.
Okay, and an N. You
want
Steven or Steven?
Yeah, Steven, whatever.
Hey, that's right, I just spelled my name.
There we go.
The strangest thing I ever signed was a chia pet.
What?
You know those chia pets on TV?
Yeah. Yes, I do.
How did they came
out? Oh, but see, now that's funny, because I don't try to be a role model for glamour. You know, this glamour thing, I mean, when I go home, believe me, I take off the makeup, I put a mud mask on my face, my hair goes up in a ponytail. You know, I don't look any different from anybody else.
Us bikers all look alike. Mistaken identity. No, this bike's kosher.
This one.
Don't drink it again. This one is.
Don't drink it again.
Drink
it public.
It's real.
All right. No. Cheap
certification.
It's real.
How are you doing?
Yeah. What is that?
That's a director or somebody.
The wasteland under the Brooklyn Bridge is Peter Lindbergh's favorite location. Setting beautiful girls against urban squalor produces an obvious frisson. Across the river is Manhattan, where the beauty business became an industry back in the 50s. Fifth Avenue was the capital of chic, and Madison the capital of advertising. But Peter took to bringing his girls downtown, to places like the old meat market. I couldn't help noticing the irony of this.
Building New York City, the air of meat market.
Once again with Shirley Bassey's annual visit to Carnegie Hall for three nights only, September 12th, 13th, and 14th.
Old Ringo, he's a man,
the man's a mind. Tickets are on sale now at all Ticketmaster locations, the Carnegie Hall box office, and a charge by phone, call 212-247-7800. Shirley Bassey in her only area appearance, September 12th, 13th, and 14th. Tickets are on sale now. To charge by phone, call 212-347-7800.
Many people said I would never live to see the day when the door to freedom from the Soviet Union would be open. But I held on to my dream of living in Israel. I never lost hope. I have been ready for 75 years.
Dreams don't cost money. Planes are the street. Thanks to your donations to UGA Federation's Operation Exodus.
Patitz is a vegetarian, but it didn't bother her that she would be filmed in the meat market. She plays the supermodel with serene detachment. Tatiana would rather be swimming with dolphins. She told me not to eat a tuna salad because dolphins live in the same waters and end up in the cans. And when a girl in fishnets tells you that, you have to believe it. Tatiana holds a mystery for everyone who works with her. They wonder how she can remain so aloof in the temperamental world of modeling. They admire the way she reconciles a passion for nature with a love of the creative excitement of fashion photography.
I do choose the photographers I work with, and the people I work with. I love creativity, I have a passion for creativity. I have all those things, so I'm willing really to give as much as I can for it. Creativity to me is life, in a sense, to the different parts that you have to portray, the different things, something that comes out of you in a, it's all inspirational. I love to experience it, I love to give to it, I love to give it as it feeds me, because it feeds me in an incredible way. It's something that, you know, it's almost like a little fire inside of you burning for it. When you get into the business, this business, is when you're very young and you have to grow up really fast. And you have to overcome a lot of fears, you have to overcome a lot of obstacles on that path that is, it's painful at times. Nature has taught me a whole lot, very much. You reach that kind of inner patience, peace, all those things. You have things, I meditate, I do things to help myself out, basically learning how to be true to myself. If I had a wish for my personal life, I'd wish for to always be happy.
She's not from Ethiopia.
Nah, man, nowhere near Ethiopia.
No, the other one's from Ethiopia. She lives in Paris.
In fact, she's not far. She comes from Jamaica, which I guess is right.
She is, right?
From Ethiopia.
No, that's from the West. Oh, she's coming out. Yeah, we gotta go over there.
She's coming out.
Next step, bro. Oh, bro. Oh, she's stepping out.
Relax, Papa. Relax.
Doesn't need to be eyes.
That's a perfect woman.
She's slammed. She's about 6'2". Yeah.
Woman is so good, she's black, so no, she's exact.
In a Brooklyn point of view. That's right.
It was my last day with the girls, and Peter wanted to spend it out at Coney Island. Naomi had the homeboys jockeying to catch a glimpse. They couldn't believe it really was Naomi Campbell, a supermodel in the flesh. By this time, I was getting used to the idea.
Going for a swim?
I can't swim.
Well, what's on your personal lifeguard?
Just made my day, Naomi.
Wow. That was nice. Good thing. Yeah.
What? They know who you are. But they're going to know a Cindy more than tomorrow.
Oh, yeah.
And Paul.
Here. What are you doing, guys?
You.
Now you're not afraid of anything. I do.
Who are you?
It's good?
I already had one for breakfast.
Can I have some Tabasco?
I hate them. I love honey. That's why I like them, but I don't.
Oh, it's nothing that you don't got. It's just how she has it.
I don't understand.
She's tall. She's got a doll's face, you know, she's like, I don't know, she's just pretty.
That's why she's
more than pretty.
She's your favorite out of the three.
No, I came because they told me Cindy Crawford might be here. That's why I came to New York. I haven't seen her yet, hope to see her later.
Here,
she's a native.
Born and raised.
Born and raised.
Tony.
I live right over there in those projects.
Projects?
Came hop, skip, and a jump. Came to meet my gang here, you know.
Huh?
Actually, I heard that Nels is good on a Thursday night, but I haven't been there yet.
Thursday night,
Nels? Yeah, that rap
doing
night.
This Thursday?
This Thursday, I'm going to Spain. Getting Barcelona. Won't be here.
How about next Thursday?
I will be next
Thursday.
How
about 5 Thursdays from now?
5 Thursdays from now, I'll be in Italy.
I think she's God's gift to the world. She's as perfect as they come. Personally, I do believe that.
You never see anybody as good, right?
No.
Not live,
she's
brother.
A piece of art, you know. She's very artistic, you know.
Piece of artwork, right?
Yeah. Priceless artwork.
Thank you.
You know, right?
Well, no one ain't
gonna
buy
me. So she's sitting next to me, I will take off my glasses.
Oh,
but I wish you would take yours off. I would love to see your eyes. Can you take a picture of me and her, Edison? Come on. Without her glasses?
Leave it behind. Leave it behind.
Further. Bobby, out the way, you're covering her legs, man. That's what we're
doing. Edison! Priceless, huh?
How do you like being surrounded by lifeguards, though? Safe.
You're all like that?
Yeah,
yes.
You
may not look it, but we are.
You all work on this beach?
Yes,
yep.
Right
over there.
Pull up, I'm getting
some tan.
Naomi,
what does it take? Push?
Naomi, you want a tan?
No, nothing materialistic, actually.
What does
she
it take?
Personality? Simple, gentle.
We all want love and affection.
Being a real person, right?
No.
She wants somebody real, somebody who's not fake, and somebody who's not
and
in the
somebody
business.
Who's there.
I'm real. Can I cut myself and show you?
No!
Somebody who's there? I'll stay. I won't even work if you don't want me to.
But you been in love before?
Yeah, I'm in love now.
For who?
I ain't can.
I'm jealous. Yeah.
In love now. How long is this one gonna last?
What's this one
lasted a long time? This one's lasted a long time.
Are there bells at the end of this one?
I don't know. I can't see that far.
Not.
I don't know. I don't know.
Disappoint a lot
I
of
yes
us.
And I ain't saying no.
Come on, Naomi.
I would like to be. Isn't that every woman's dream?
No, you're only 21.
I'm only 21, so.
You have a whole future ahead of you.
Don't jeopardize in this one guy. If it was me, I would say something different.
Personally, I think marriage is the first step towards divorce.
She's a lovely girl. Sure.
The snake didn't belong to Tatiana, but the baby was Stephanie's. Little Dylan Thomas travels everywhere with his mother. Stephanie is a sensitive flower child from California, the supermodel who has it all. Looks, money, fame, a rock star boyfriend, and a baby. Would be somewhere else, in front of other cameras. I had never seen anybody exposed to so much film. Every time they turned their heads, cameras snapped and videos rolled. It was the rage for beauty. Beauty is terror, said Jean-Luc Godard. For these girls, beauty was destiny. They hate being called girls and would like to be thought of as women.
Such romantic illusions, and they're all about you. I'll sell them all.
Yeah, she always wanted to be a model. My mom's very, very beautiful. We don't look alike, really. More like my father, but you know, she always wanted to be a model, so she wanted that for me, I think. So she could sort of live through it.
Here.